Armesha and I, we met last year sometime. We started messing around and stuff like that. Everything was cool at first, you know what I'm saying? We ain't really had no problems. And then, like, she just started getting controlling. Like, she think she want me to have an ankle bracelet on. Look, I can't have no ankle bracelet on. I ain't in jail. I ain't no house arrest. Yeah, I'm going to be around, but I can't be around you 24/7. I'm working 84 hours a week. Night shift at that. She called me talking about some, you gave me an STD. I got an STD. Bam. I ain't give you no STD. I work 84 hours a week. I know she ain't get the STD from me because I got tested right after she called me. Boom, I came back clean. Gotcha. It wasn't me. After I found out about the STD, I cut her off. We just started back talking like a month ago, but we've been arguing about it ever since. She putting the blame on me, but whole time, I know she the one cheating. I really think she smashed one of the guys while I was locked up. And I also think she slept with a few of my family members too while I was locked up. I found out she was texting one of my friends and stuff like that. So I'm like, oh yeah, y'all really got something going on. Like, she making me look bad to everybody. Like, I'm a dirty, like, so females don't even want to mess with me. They think I'm dirty. And it's all because she caught the STD and trying to blame it on me. So we came all the way out here to the show. And I passed out drunk at the hotel. And I think she went to go see one of her friends from New York. And I'm pretty sure they had sex. I can't wait to clear my name. I ain't getting nobody no STD. And if she failed a lot of detector tests, she gone. I mean, she gone. There ain't nothing to talk about.
Armesha, that's your boyfriend on the tape. What do you feel about what he's saying?
I'm very pissed off what he said. Yeah.
Tell me what happened.
Okay, so I went to the doctor the 23rd because I just had pain in my stomach. So I went to the doctor. And the doctor, he asked me, like, do you think you have STD? I'm like, no, I don't think I got what he took. He was like, well, could we take a specimen to see? I'm like, yes. He took it. It came back that I had chlamydia. So I called him. And I'm like, call me, pick up the phone. So then he picked up the phone. I'm like, who you been sleeping with, dealing with? He's like, nobody. Why? I'm like, because I just got tested and I have an STD. And he was like, it's impossible. That had to come from you. He hung up.
He hung up on you?
Yes, he hung straight up. So I had to finish getting the treatment. After the treatment, I drove 3 hours to his job because I wanted answers. Since he didn't want to talk on the phone, I get to his job about 6 o'clock. He didn't get off till 7. So I'm standing in the hotel just upset because I'm waiting on him to give me answers. So when he see me, he laughed like, what you doing here? I'm doing here. I need you to tell me, like, what's going on? Like, where did this come from? I didn't have it. I didn't have it. Well, how did it come? I know I didn't cheat, so how did I get it? So that was on the 23rd. He didn't go get tested till December 12th. He's working at a hospital, so he had to get it cleared up.
So you do believe that he was cheating on you, right?
Yeah.
Okay. But he never admitted it?
No.
What happened in October?
October. Okay, so October, I was in the process of getting ready to move. He had to run and go get his son from Indiana. So we got in a little argument. He used to pick arguments a lot just for him to go cheat. I swear to God, he'd do every time to go cheat. So we gets in an argument, I'm in the process of moving. I'm like, you're not finna get me on my hookup for moving to throw me off just for you to cheat. So automatically, like, oh, you meant hook up with So now I'm finna take this girl to Disney World. This happened within less 24 hours, so this was already planned. How you just call a girl up and say, let's go to Disney World?
Now, he believes that you're the one who cheated. He believes that you had sex with his friends and family members while he was in jail.
Correct.
Did you?
No.
How long was he away for?
24 hours. No, less than 24 hours.
What? I thought you were going to say, like, 2 years or something.
He
was in jail for 24 hours.
Not even 24 hours.
And he thinks that you slept with friends and family members.
Yes.
Oh, okay, that just blows my mind. I really thought you were going to say, like, 18 months, 2 years, 3 years.
He probably no more than 7 hours. He was in jail.
Yeah, you'd have to get real busy in that amount of time to do all that. Now, you got a crazy text message this weekend?
Yes. It was the girl telling me, like, you can keep him. And I'm like, keep who? So I'm keep getting a call from this number, but they not answering like they want me to call back. So then I finally get a, you can keep him. Keep who? She like, him. Oh, so I asked him, like, who is that? So then he kept trying to throw it off and say it was this other girl. That he met her when we separated in November. That's when he started dealing with her. But he never admitted that they did anything until she texted me and told me I can have him. So I feel like he only confessed because she texted me. So if he could have kept it a secret, it would have been a secret.
All right, let's meet David.
You know I ain't get you that STD.
You know
you got the STD. I got tested a week later.
You was working at a hospital, so you think I believe it?
I got tested a week later. I was clean. I didn't have no STD.
A week later. You worked at a hospital. You could have went the day I told you.
I can't go get tested. I'm gonna work 84 hours a week.
You wasn't even doing really nothing at work, so you know how to get through it. Stop playing.
I'm working 84 hours. How you gonna say I'm not doing nothing?
It don't matter. You sit at the table.
I don't.
You in there asleep. Stop playing.
But I'm cleaning up a whole hospital.
No, you're not.
I'm cleaning up a whole hospital.
No, you're not.
I'm not just sitting
there. Yeah, but if you're in a hospital, how hard or how long would it take to get a shot?
I mean, I understand that, but I didn't. I don't got time. I'm working 84 hours a week. Every day I'm working. I don't have time.
Yeah, you get breaks, you get lunch, right?
Yeah, we do. We get breaks and we get lunch.
Right, so you didn't get it clean then?
I didn't get it clean. I even showed her my test results that said I was clean. I didn't have anything.
A week later.
But you. So I went when I had time to go. You never had it, right?
I never had an STD. Okay.
So do you believe that she got it from someone else?
She got it from someone else.
Does she act like she's a woman that cheats on you?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, but even so, like, say you get into a big fight and you break up, even for a day. Boom, you're just taking another woman to Disney
right.
World?
It was already planned. Stop lying.
Do you cheat on her?
I told her about the time.
It's just a yes or no answer.
I do not be cheating on her.
You do not cheat.
I don't be cheating on her.
You can just look at how you just talking and responding that you're just a liar.
Do you love her?
Yeah, I love her.
You love her?
I ain't gonna lie. Yeah.
You want a future with her?
I can't answer that till after these results.
Okay, let's find out. Armesha, you're up first.
Okay.
You took a lie detector test. And we asked you, besides the one man in May of 2021, while in a relationship with David, have you engaged in any sexual intercourse with any other men besides David? You answered no. While in a relationship with David, have you engaged in any physical sexual acts with any of David's family members or friends? You answered no. Last night, were you supposed to be cheating last night?
Yeah.
You were cheating last night?
Yeah, in his eyes.
Last night, the night before
okay.
last.
So anyways, last night, did you engage in any physical sexual acts with any other man besides David? She answered no. The results came back the same to all three of those questions, and it came back that Armesha told the truth. David, you go in there and you stated that you're currently in a relationship with two other women, including Armesha, a total of three women. You admitted that you engaged in physical sexual acts with 12 women since being with Armesha. 10 of those women have been sexual intercourse. All 10 have been with no condom, unprotected at some points. Most recent time you had intercourse was this past Friday night, Saturday morning, prior coming to the Steve Wilkos show with another woman. Do you get in arguments with Armesha so you can cheat on her intentionally? He answered no. Did you engage in sexual acts with any woman prior to having sex with Armesha that you gave her an STD? He answered no. Have you ever engaged in any physical sexual acts with more than 12 women while in a relationship with your girlfriend, Armesha? He answered no. And so those three questions, he told the truth. But those three questions, you're telling the truth, but you're in a relationship with two other women and you slept with 12 other women. What are you doing? You're a mom, you got kids, and you're with somebody that's completely not faithful to you at all.
Correct.
So what do you do?
Go on with my life. It's okay.
You're really gonna go on without him?
Yep.
So when you go back home, he comes knocking on your door?
He ain't gonna come knocking on my door. He gonna stay away.
All right, well, I wish you the best. Good luck to you. Good luck to you too. My name is Steve Wilkos, and I'm an investigative talk show host with a law enforcement background.
It was my life or his.
My job is to get truth and justice for everyday people. Watch our videos now.